Welcome back. We are following some shocking scenes coming out of northern India. At least 16 people are dead after record-breaking amounts of rainfall led to large-scale flash flooding and landslides. A local authority saying that the rains caused one river to overflow by over 2.5 feet above the danger mark. The Indian government has issued flood warnings throughout the region as rescue teams continue to work to locate survivors in the hardest-hit areas. And flooding is also an issue here in this country. A strong storm moved through central Oklahoma this morning, bringing heavy rain and wind. The oppressive heat also continuing this weekend, capping off a week that scientists say was the hottest week in recorded history. But meteorologist and climate specialist Jeff Berardelli writes this: as the steady drumbeat of human-caused climate heating beats on, the summer of 2023 will soon be considered a cool summer in a couple of decades. And Jeff Berardelli is joining us now. That's not easy to hear, Jeff. So thanks for the bad news. But let's get into it if we can, because, you know, what is this kind of trend of warming temperatures around the globe telling you? Like, the hottest days on record, one day after another, the ocean feeling warmer than ever as well.
None of it's surprising. It's astonishing to see it happening, but we expected this to happen. I mean, remember, we've been warming the Earth for about the past 100 years, and especially over the past 50 years or so, and it just continues unabated. Now, on top of that, this year we have a natural oscillation called El Nino, and every time we have an El Nino year, every few years or so, we're injecting a lot more heat from the Pacific Ocean on top of that baseline warming from climate change. And what we're seeing is everything come together this year for astonishing record. We're not just beating the records by a little bit. We are obliterating record to the point where we've never seen these unprecedented records that we're seeing around Earth right now.
I want to ask you about one of the leading theories, which is basically about the jet stream, right? Saying that climate change is kind of disrupting this jet stream, which is what's causing a heat dome, I guess, over Canada, parts of the South, and then leading to the hazy skies that we've been seeing a lot in the Northeast as well with these pretty high temperatures. Is that a theory that you're on board with?
Yeah, for sure. We see these jet streams becoming more amplified, more undulations, and the jet stream seems to be slowing down at times. And what happens when the jet stream slows down is it begins to undulate more and it gets stuck. So we're seeing these more high latitude blocking patterns. Sometimes, like this year, it's over Canada. Next year, it could be over Siberia. Perhaps the year after, it's going to be over the center of the United States. It varies exactly where it is, but it gets stuck for weeks and weeks on end. And it's not just one, there are several of them. So concurrent or compounding heat domes, which means that various places on Earth have heat waves at the same time, droughts at the same time, which of course makes it very hard for agriculture and can cause these shocks at the same time all over Earth, which can cause major problems. And a study just came out to confirm what I'm talking about.
So you write this as well. This may all seem hopeless, but we know exactly what the problem is. We know exactly how to fix it. And we have all the solutions that we need now. Jeff? What are they? What do we need to do? And when would we be seeing kind of the fruits of our labor, right? I kind of think about this in the way in which we've been seeing inflation, just kind of talking about something else that we've had to kind of battle over the last year, right? And what the Fed chair is doing with interest rates. I'm wondering, if we were to institute some of these solutions, when would we start to see kind of climate change start to turn around?
Okay, well, it takes a while, right? But if we stop emitting, as soon as we stop emitting, Earth's temperature stopped going up. So if we were to stop emissions, let's say in the next 20 or 30 years, at that point where we no longer are emitting, and perhaps we begin to suck some of that carbon dioxide back out of the atmosphere, at that point, we stop warming the atmosphere. That matters. Every tenth of a degree matters. But yes, you're going to have to wait to see fruit of your labor. We have already injected a lot of heat into the atmosphere and the oceans. The heat that we've injected into the oceans will be there for hundreds and hundreds of years, melting ice. Yeah. We might be able to slow the progression of that kind of thing, but a lot of sea level rise is baked in, which means we're going to see meters of sea level rise in the future. The key here is slowing it down so we can adapt and nature, animals and plants can adapt as well.
Jeff Berardelli, thank you so much. Appreciate it.